this video, I'm going to talk about referencing the content that you add to Physiopedia. It's really important that we acknowledge other people's work that we use in Physiopedia, and we do this by referencing. Now, there's this page on Physiopedia titled Referencing, which goes into detail about what referencing is, why you need to reference the work, and what references you should use. Before you do anything, I recommend that you read this article in Physiopedia and just be sure that you're familiar with the reason that we reference the work that we add to Physiopedia. If we are going to add references, there is a specific way that we do that in Physiopedia. So this is my new page on sleep, and I've been doing some research and I found this article here. Now, my take-home message from this article is that there's no current knowledge for the effectiveness of physiotherapy on sleep disturbance in people with low back pain. So I'm going to add that to my site here. I'm going to edit the page. And this is just an example of how we would do referencing. So I've concluded from my reading that there is no knowledge for the effectiveness of physiotherapy on sleep disturbance in people with low back pain. Now, obviously, I haven't made that up myself. I've taken that from the reading that I've done, from the literature searching around the topic. So what I need to do then is acknowledge that this has come from someone else's work. And the way we do that is with the referencing tool. So I simply place my cursor where I'd like the reference to be at the end of the piece of text that I've added and use this cite tool. So we're going to enter a basic reference here. Before we do that, I need to actually get the reference. So I'm just going to go back to my article. This is my article, and we use Vancouver referencing in Physiopedia, which also is explained on a page in Physiopedia. And the way that I find how I'm going to format the reference is I use this Chrome Google Scholar extension in Chrome. So this is it, it's the Google Scholar button. Now, I highly recommend that everyone adds this to Chrome and uses Chrome. So I have added this to Chrome, which is my browser. This gives me this little academic hat here, which I can click on. What this will do is actually format the reference for me. So it brings up this article, which is the article that we're looking at. And if I click on the quotation marks here, it will give me the citation. So we use Vancouver, so I simply copy the Vancouver reference. And then I can go back to my Physiopedia page where I wanted to add the citation and place it in there. We could simply save by clicking insert here, but what I actually like to do and what's really, really useful in Physiopedia is add a link to the article. So I've copied the article link, which is particularly useful for an article like this, which is open access that people can then go on and read. And back in my reference here, I'm going to add a link to the article on the title. So I highlight the title of the article, go to the chain link, and I'm going to add the link to the article. That's normally all I do with the reference, and then I insert it into the page. So you can see there that the reference has been automatically added at the bottom with a link directly to that article, which is really, really useful for people who are reading the page and want to find out more. Now, if I want to use a reference twice on one page, so I'll have some more text. And let's say that I've taken this piece of content from reading the same article as above, and I want to add the same reference. I want to acknowledge the same article for this piece of content that I've added. There's one slight difference here. So we again go to the site, but we use reuse. And then what happens, it will bring up a list of all the articles that have already been used, referenced on the page. And I can simply click on that, and it will add it again for me. And what that does is just says that it's been used at the bottom. It doesn't add it again, but it gives it a second reference at the bottom saying it's been used twice on the page. Then, as always, don't forget to save your page. And there you have it. You can see the two references inserted onto the page, and you can do that as many times as you like. And we highly recommend that you reference everything that you add to Physiopedia.